So, today, before the start of the class, I welcome you again into the online English classes. I hope everybody might be enjoying the quarantine period at their home.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let us start. Yesterday, we have read about the... Pardon? Ab boliye.
Okay.
Second bend. So, Ishwaran has an amazing capacity of producing vegetable that we have already finished. Now, the third paragraph. Mahendra would be early in the morning. That part is also finished. Here, from this chapter, his description. His own description. And here you see, yesterday I have already told you that telling a story is a beautiful art. What you need to mix the body language, the expressions, and the wild imaginations. All these things, if it is mixed properly, then you are able to narrate a story beautifully. Why Ishwaran was successful as a storyteller? Because of his own description. The way he described the story, it was something amazing. It was something praiseworthy. And that is why the narrator has chosen the very title of the story, Ishwaran the Storyteller. What he said, descriptions were generally infused by the Tamil author's spirit. Most of his narratives, most of his description of the story, he draw it from a very famous Tamil authors that he usually used to read. Yesterday, I have hit upon the very importance of reading. You see, my dear friend, reading gives you information. Mahendra, though he was a cook, but every day he used to read thousands of the pages. This is something remarkable. Though he is not a student like you, though he is not a teacher like me, but see his interest. What is the thing that we should take out? We need to take an example that unless or until we are not reading something, we are not able to narrate any incident. Here you see, most of his descriptions, what he said, that most of his descriptions were based on Tamil authors that he used to read. When he was narrating even the smallest incident, when he narrates even the smallest incident, he would try to work in suspense. Here you see how he used to narrate his story. Even the smallest thing is narrated. Narrated with what? Great suspense and a surprise of incident. He would try the work in suspense and ending into the output. For example, instead of saying that he had come across an uprooted tree on a highway. Simply, here you see, when he starts narrating a story, instead of saying that he came across an uprooted tree, here you see how he mixes his imaginations. Here you see how he is mixing his imagination, how he is mixing his own descriptions. What he says, he would say, with eyebrow, that is a gesture, suitable gesture. What he will with a suitable gesture. Gesture is what? The look, the body language. With a suitable gesture, eyebrow arched and hand hold out in dramatic gesture. Eyebrows, look at the language, look at the use of the body, the hand, the eyebrow, and the face, facial expressions. Now, what he say? The road was deserted. Here you see, the road was deserted. The road was deserted. Deserted and I was all alone. Suddenly, Suddenly I spotted something. Something. That looked like an enormous bushy beast. Here you see how, look at his own description. Look at the way he mixes his own description. Most of his descriptions were influenced by Tamil authors that he used to read. Here you see how he is mixing his own descriptions. A simple tree that was, for example, instead of saying that he had come across an uprooted tree on the highway. Simple, what he have seen? An uprooted tree on the highway. Here you see how he is mixing his own imagination. Here you see, the road was deserted. Look at the dramatic way. Look at the suspense. Look at the suspense that Ishwaran is trying to create to the listener of the story. The road was deserted. Look at the dramatic way. And I was all alone. A very suitable environment. He is trying to paint a very, very suitable environment to make his story effective. Effective storytelling is an art. And if you could learn this is the one of the beautiful way that how could you start effective storytelling. Effective storytelling is an art. Let us see. Next, what he say? That I was alone. Suddenly I spotted. Look at the imaginations. How beautifully he is mixing the imagination and creating a very favorable conditions, favorable environment, favorable background of the story. You see, narrators and the storyteller or the director of the film, if they have a true sense of telling the story, they will keep a tight grip on the story. Here you see, suddenly looked like an enormous bushy beast lying on the, he's not telling that it is, he's calling it, it was a bushy beast, though it was a tree, but she called that it was a bushy beast. So here you see how Ishwaran narrates his story. Now, bushy beast, Astra, I was half inclined to turn and go back. Again, then what? After that, what he says? He was half inclined. He was half inclined to turn and go back. But as I climbed closer, I saw that it was a fallen tree. It was a fallen tree. Here you see how a simple incident of a tree, uprooted tree, lying on the highway is narrated. How beautifully Ishwaran, the storyteller, has narrated. How he mixes his own imagination, own body language, own atmosphere. You see, atmosphere of the story is very important. If you are able to create a suitable atmosphere, suitable use of sound, light, and body language, by your eyes are the best, your eyes and hands and the face, these are the three things that helps you as a best communicator. Your eyes, expression of your eyes and eyebrows, and then the vibrations of the sound, the various sound that you create. So these are the things that helps to tell a very good story. Now come to the next. Then what she said? But as I came closer, I saw that it was a fallen tree with its dry branches spread out. Mahendra would stretch himself back in his canvas chair and listen to tales of uncertainty. And how his master Mahendra believes it is an everyday incident that Ishwaran narrates a typical unique stories. And Mahendra sits in his chair attentively and listens all the narratives very carefully. Now come next. The place I come from is a famous for timber. The place Ishwaran would begin. Now, what are the further parts of this story? Then again, the place I come from is a famous for timber. Now the Ishwaran is again starting. And there is a richly wooden forest all around. How the story is progressing? How he is linking? You see, arranging your story, how arrangement of the story, here you see. Arrangement of the story. How beautifully Mahendra is arranging his story in sequence sequence. If your story is arranged in a correct sequence, it will rouse the curiosity of the listener and you will be a very successful storyteller. So, the logs and the howl of the lorries by the river. They are huge, well-fed beasts. Elephants are huge, well-fed beasts. When they turn wild, even the most experienced Mahavat, Mahavat is the driver, Mahavat. One who guides the elephant. Sitting on his head, on his back. So, somebody, you might have seen somebody sitting at the back of the elephant and he is having something like an iron stick or something which has a pointed sharp, and that is from that they used to guide the elephant, and that person is known as a Mahavat, the driver, the trainer who trains the elephant and guides the elephant sitting on its back, that is on the very top of the elephant, near the neck and on the head, he keeps guiding. So, Mahavat launch into the elaborated anecdotes involving an elephant. Here you see how he is involving an elephant into the story. In fact, there was no elephant in the story. But in order to make the story interesting, you see, you need some extra knowledge to make something interesting. As a storyteller, you are the storyteller. So you should know that what are the things that is to be mixed in your story. And if you are able to mix everything beautifully, your story is a very successful story, my dear friend. So it's you. It is up to you. How beautifully you mix the stories. Now come to the next. One day a tusker escaped. Now the elephant is narrating the story that he was leaving the area that was surrounded by the forest. And there was the wild elephants, the elephant who used to carry the logs, the wooden, the logs generally in the forest that has been cut and it is pulled by the elephants. So heavy logs. So then what happens to that elephant? How that elephant gets wild? Here you see. One day the tusker escaped from the timber yard and began to roam about. So what happened? One day, a tusker, that is elephant. Tusker, comma mein bracket mein likh dijiye, elephant. A tusker escaped from the timber yard here you see how he is exaggerating. How he is exaggerating. Exaggeration. How he is making his story more interesting. by exaggerations, by hyperbole. What is a hyperbole? It is a part of a fiction. When something is exaggerated, when something is narrated more than that or less than that, that's the reality is. Here you see how he is aggravating, how he is mixing his wild imagination, how he is narrating to make his story more and more interesting. Here you see that the tusker that escaped, run away, fled away. From where? From the timber yard. If something is escaped, it is run away unnoticed. And stamping the bush. What happened when it was a wild tusker? What happened? Stamping on bushes. Stomping and bushes, tearing up wild creepers, what are the actions? Here you see how the sequence of the story he is presenting. Though it is his own descriptions, but here you see the elephant escapes, and when it escapes, it is running here and there. It is running here and there without the mahavat. So what it will do? Stamping on bushes. It will crush the bush that it will come on in, under its feet. Tearing up the wild creepers. The wild creepers that has grown. Teared by the elephant, and it was running here and there. And breaking the branches. Here you see. Breaking the branches. Breaking the branches. Here you see. Breaking the branches. Breaking the branches at their will. Here you see. The elephant, the tusker that escaped from the timber yard, stamping on the bush, tearing the wild creepers, and breaking the branches. So all the incident appears to be true. So this is the art that Ishwaran was gifted with. And we need to learn from Ishwaran that how we could be a good or successful storyteller. Here you see why it is prescribed to you, why it is prescribed in class 9, because in your writing portion there is a part that is story writing. And without, see, you can take the note down these points. All these points. What is writing? From known to unknown. A story writing is a known part. And this is a known part. The known part that I am telling you, that I am teaching you. And this known part, the chapter Ishwaran the Storyteller, will help you to write a very, very good story. So for sure, a story writing is going to come in your examination. So please take it as a more important. Take it as a more important. Because this will help you to learn how to store in iron. So here you see how he is mixing. Then what happened? Tearing the all the branches. You know, sir, how an elephant behaves when it goes mad. Now, the elephant goes mad. So here he is talking about how the elephant goes mad. What he said? You know, sir. You know, sir, how an elephant behave behaves when it goes mad. Here you see how he is putting the fact, though it is a pure imagination, though it is pure his brainchild. What is a brainchild? What is your brainchild? It is own. It is his own thought. A brainchild is something that is the outcome of your imagination. So it was just, see how beautifully, how smartly, and how beautifully. Eshwaran is mixing, he is interlinking, he is mixing the story with his wild imagination. So dear friend, dear student, please see how you could write a good story. Then what happened to the next? Eshwaran would get so caught up in the excitement of his own story that he would get up from the floor and jump up. Here you see, he was so engrossed, he was so captivated while narrating his story, even if he jumped. Why he jumped? It was a body language, use of body language. Jumping, showing the fist in agitations, twisting the eyes and the eyebrow, the facial expressions, all the things. But suppose you are writing, how could you use your body language? Your words are your body language, my dear friend. You can use the words. Here you see, jump. I jumped. No sooner did I saw. I smacked. I jumped. I was about to cry. So this is the words. You select the particular words. Word will express your body language, your anguish, your anger, your surprise, and your imaginations. So here you see, jumped out, stamping his feet in emulations of the mad elephant. And he himself stamped like that. So this is what a good storyteller can tell. So here you have, I suppose, this part of the story you might have understood. Now it is your turn to ask your question. I request you, if you have any query, please ask. I am here to solve your queries. But I am very sorry that you are not putting any query in box. I request you again to watch the online class video, join the online classes, and watch the online class video so that you can raise your questions and you can clear your doubt. So thank you. This is from my part. Now it is your part. Please ask the question.